Andiamo, andiamo.
Good morning to everybody. So I am academic counselor of IGNU. Name is H. Biswas, and today the MMPH G07, that is compensation and reward management. Today we have to discuss about the block 2. Block 2 is a legal frameworks of the compensation and rewards. So within this block, there are two units, that is unit number 5 and unit number 6. Unit number 5 is your legal framework of compensation and the rewards. Unit number 6 is your legal frameworks. So both the units are covered up regarding the framework, what the way the, it has the policies, and the, what are the acts of theirs, basically the wage salaries, fictions, that part is there, and what type of rewards means the benefits are required for the motivation of the employees. So all these things are discussed over these things. So if we see, try to understand the introduction part of the things. What is the salary compensation packages? As we say in the compensation package. So which means that there are, where the wages means their basic salaries, then your DAs, general allowance, and other so many things are to be there. So basically the administration of the compensation is a significant aspect of human resource management, this part. Because when your people are working in organizations and you are taking some work from him as an hour, as a time basis, then you have to pay something for his work. What equivalent to money, in terms of money, you have to provide it. And the salary objectives is salary or the packages should be in such a way so that you can survive socially. And you can develop to some extent, or you can save the monies accordingly. So that means it should be a work basis. So salary structure is not a, it is a challenge, very challenging job. So but fixation of the wages basically. And as you know, we know that corporate companies are different wage packages. Private companies are different wage packages. So every company have a different policies. Government, private, and your autonomous, whatever the things, there are some grading system, levels are also there. Grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, that is the way they are physics, depending on the levels, depending on the work, and based on this. So, so it is influenced when we are fixing the wages, there is some mechanism is there. The, what the way that it is formulated basically. So that things are influenced by the your internal and external factors as also there. So both the factors are play in the time of fixation process. So compensation through the preliminary involves economic considerations, but various other factors like the social, then your psychological, political, and ethical factors have their relevance. So there are so many things are involved, because economy is one of the main considerations. Now other factors, for example, the psychological, then your political, ethical, all these things are there. It means some area. So area are defined, this area are wages would be in such a way so that you can maintain these that areas. Now the concept of the wages, remunerations capable of being expressed in the terms of money, which would in the terms of the contract of the employment, expressed or the implied, where it is fulfilled. By payable to a person's employed in respect of his important or the work done. Means in simplification, as you say, you have bought something which is already settled by the organizations, and you have performed this, you have the completions of the work you have done. It is estimated earlier, and based on this, this much amount are to be given. So that is the basically the remunerations level. So we can say that with the payment, the remuneration is a service rendered. You have given some service, and because of that, you are paying something. As we just, for example, we are recruiting some of the maid in the house, basically. So we have fixed it. Okay, 5,000 rupees I will give you per month. You have to wash dishwashes, cleaning the house, rooms, etc. You have to define the things. That service is basically, sometimes it has happened also. Maybe for dishwashings, you are paying some of the, suppose for example, 1,000. For cleaning of the rooms, 3 rooms or 4 rooms, 1,000. You have defined the works also. And accordingly, you have to pay total amount as a package. Now, wages have classified into 6 broad categories. Now, there are 6 categories are there. Statutory minimum wages, because it is a rule by the regulation by the government. Government has already regulated, and government has defined this below this amount you cannot give. This is the minimum wages for 18,000 or 60,000, whatever that has been. It is time to time it is changing, by the rules are changing time to time. Not immediately, it may be after 4 years or 5 years, the labor ministry systems. They are depending on the economy conditions. They are revised things. So minimum wages has been have to pay basically settled by the corporate. Number three is to bear the subsistence or the minimum wages, because for the survival purposes for the month, this much money is required so that he can save his family and your own belongings like this. Living wages, because he has to take some food, rental houses or clothes. So for the living purposes, that are to be considered. Then fair wages, conveyance charges or all these things, that charges also you have to consider during the wage revisions, basically the wage revision times. Then need-based minimum wages. What is actually the need for these things? So that's the way you have to fix it. So basically, there are 6 broad categories. Considering the need, fair, living, subsistence, and the what are the statutory defined by the regulations. Now, economic aspects of the wage determinations. Some of the areas. Employee compensation is an important component of cost of the productions for the employers. The worker being a seller of the worker being the seller of the labor aspects. So labor aspects to get the highest price from the employer, but then in return to the work he has done for the employer. Because you see here some of the things are employee, worker and the employers. So in turn is return. Means suppose the employer give in turn, return some of the things, and accordingly suppose the salary I am getting this month. So I have to pay also to my employer, because that much work I have to tell. Based on this, the employer again, he will be allowed to give some salaries or wages. So it is a vice versa. This is just some sort of we can say the complementary each other, basically. The complementary each other. sociological aspect of the wage determinations. So another determination is the employee's compensation is an important component, the cost of the production of the employees. Then your sociological aspect of the wage determinations, political considerations in the form of the power and the influence, you have to bearing the compensation issues. What are the issues are there? Sometimes it is the political power is there, affiliations, and the trade union is one of the involvement there in this process. So the determination in that sense, basically the who are the components, which are the elements are involved from this legal framework purposes. Definitely the employer, the key roles, then your political representatives, trade unions, they are the key elements. I mean, as a team in the panels, they are to bargain each other's and debate whatever the things, their issues has to be addressed. So everything are combined, then final a collective bargaining process, through this process has to be, that fixation has to be decided. So government is also interference in deciding wage related issues, curtailing the freedom of the participants to decide wage issues of their own. Sometimes the government is also taking some steps, because especially in the minimum wages, otherwise from the government bodies, regulations, they are not intervening any other things. If the fringe benefits or some of the allowances are declared by the companies, there it may be independence. I mean, in that case, it is decided by the organizations and their unions. Often is the objective look, that is minimum wages that should be at par with the economic conditions of the workers. So another thing is the bonus, suppose. So that case, gratuities or your opt-in fund, that part company is deciding, they are giving their rules and guidelines and advice also to the board, basically that time of fixations. And especially where the government wage divisions, central government wage divisions or state government, they are deciding their at part their levels, different grades, and deciding how much should be the lower grade, increment, rate of increment, scale of the wages, everything are decided by the legislation bodies and the wage board decision. Then the ethical aspect is also important. This is another determinant. Ethical, there should be no fairness in the law, in the norms for the which are taken into the consideration for the wages. Wages should commensurate with their efforts. They are not exploited, and there is no discriminations on wages on the basis of caste, color, sex, and religions. It means the ethical part, basically they are think there should not be any ambiguities. Everybody should feel happy, respect each other, that efforts has to be given. They should not feel exploited. The salary is within minimum and I'm working hard, or this much money may not be survived. So this, that type of feelings or caste variations or any groupisms, I mean the discrimination of the caste should not be, considering all this as equal conditions have to be considered, so that in future there should not be any the debate or any problems should not be arise within the ultimately aim is the interpersonal relations between the workers, between the employees, should be retained. I mean, should be maintained and retained. There should not be any spark. Basically, the I think so they found some any for ego or some of the your conflict. This should not be any conflict between these anybody's. So to avoid the things that are conflict, stress and the egos, so that's the basically part of your ethical aspect that you consider when everybody are feel happy. Now corporate compensation policies are important. Compensation policies of the corporation and the individual organizations has to consider the simultaneously the community concerns, then economic and social.
Thank you.